the litter box is a dirty job. As a cat owner, it used to be my most hated household chore, yet it was the one that nagged me the most. As a veterinary emergency critical care specialist, I've seen way too many medical problems from having a dirty litter box. That's why I'm adamant that you need to scoop daily or use an automatic litter robot that does it for you. You want to make sure your cat has a clean box of litter as often as possible to help minimize two medical problems: feline lower urinary tract disease, what I'll call flute D from now on, or the more life-threatening urinary blockage called feline urethral obstruction, or FUO. Signs of flute D and FUO are hard to distinguish from each other, as they're very similar. One isn't an emergency, yet the other, FUO, can be life-threatening. With an FUO, the poisons from your cat's kidneys build up in the bloodstream from the inability to urinate, resulting in temporary kidney failure, salt balance abnormalities, and rarely, death. For this reason, you want to minimize the risk of either occurring, while also carefully monitoring your cat for any of these clinical signs, which is where the litter robot with Connect is helpful. You can check how often your cat is using the box from the technology of your smartphone. Signs of feline lower urinary tract disease and feline urethral obstruction include making multiple trips to the litter box, acting constipated, straining to urinate, urinating in weird or unusual places like the bathtub, potted plants, the sink, etc., excessive licking of the perineal region, including the region of the penis or prepuce, howling or crying excessively, acting painful when picked up, not eating, hiding or acting lethargic, and vomiting. There's a couple of important things of what I call is kitty litter husbandry. That means how clean the litter box is. If you leave the litter box really full, it's gross, it's dirty, it stinks. And remember, cats are such fastidious creatures, they don't want to step in a dirty litter box too often. They may choose to only urinate once a day instead of 2 to 3 times a day. When this happens, their urine becomes really concentrated, and with it, red blood cells, mucus plugs, or even crystals can become more concentrated. This can potentially result in signs of either flute D or FUO. That's why having a clean litter box is essential to good cat health. My general rule, you need to have N+1 traditional litter boxes per cat. In other words, if you have one cat, you need N+1 litter boxes. In other words, 2 litter boxes. If you have 3 cats, you need 3+1 litter boxes, a total of 4. Why? It's because cats are territorial and often will use one specific litter box. If you have a litter robot automatic kitty litter box, typically 1 per 3 to 4 cats is sufficient, since litter robot provides a clean bed of litter after every use. The next important thing is scooping daily. Just because you have more litter boxes doesn't mean you need to scoop less. I want you to scoop every single day. Yes, I know it's a dirty job, but it's really important for your cat's kidney and urinary health. Again, crystals, grit, red and white blood cells, and mucus clumps can get more concentrated, getting stuck in the urethra, the tube leading from the bladder to the exterior of the body. This becomes more of a problem in male cats, as their urethra is narrower. As an emergency critical care veterinary specialist, I end up seeing a lot of cats in the ER for inappropriate urination. When this happens, cat owners often wonder if their cat has a urinary tract infection, or a UTI. I want you to be able to recognize the clinical signs of what a UTI can look like. That includes symptoms such as excessive grooming of the genital area, frequent attempts to urinate or making multiple trips to the litter box, squatting to urinate in front of you, or urinating in unusual places outside of the litter box, like on plastic bags, on your laundry, or in the bathtub or sink, signs of vomiting, lethargy, abnormal smelling urine, the absence of large clumps in the litter box, straining to urinate, acting painful, such as meowing or crying when using the litter box or being picked up, having discolored urine, in other words, it looks like there's blood in it, If you have an automatic litter robot with Connect, you can actually check your smartphone to see how often your cat is using the box. Cats normally visit the box 1 to 4 times a day, and if it's more than that, it may indicate a medical problem. The majority of the time, these urinary signs are due to a sterile inflammation of the bladder, what we call FLUTD, or feline lower urinary tract disease. And honestly, it's rarely from a urinary tract infection. First, know that UTIs are very rare in young cats. These infections are more often seen in older cats, greater than 10 years of age. Some studies estimate that less than 2% of the time, male cats presenting with these signs end up having a UTI. However, the clinical signs of UTI are very similar to both feline lower urinary tract disease or feline urethral obstruction. So, how do we tell the difference between these problems? How do we diagnose a cat with a UTI? To tell the difference, we veterinarians need to perform an appropriate medical workup that includes a physical exam, a urine sample, which is ideally performed via a sterile technique called the cystocentesis, and a urine culture. First, when we perform a thorough physical exam, we're going to palpate your cat's bladder. With a urinary tract infection, a small painful bladder is often present, as compared to a large, distended, non-expressible bladder with a feline urethral obstruction or blockage. Furthermore, smaller amounts of foul-smelling, blood-tinged urine may be seen in the cat carrier or actually on the fur. The next preliminary tests include obtaining a sterile urine sample. We veterinarians are looking at how concentrated the urine is. Normal urine-specific gravity, or concentration, in cats is greater than a urine-specific gravity of 0.050, or what vets typically call 1050. We also want to evaluate if there's any evidence of white blood cells, red blood cells, crystals, or even bacteria on a microscopic examination. The most definitive test to diagnose a UTI is with a urine culture. And this is when we grow the urine in a microbiology plate to see if certain types of bacteria grow. This typically takes 2 to 3 days for us to grow the bacteria and get the results back. How do we treat a cat with a urinary tract infection? Treatment typically includes using oral antibiotics for at least 1 week, which means you need to be able to pill your cat once to twice a day. Or we can potentially use an injection of an antibiotic called Convenia that lasts for 1 week that goes under the skin. Follow-up includes rechecking another sterile urine sample 2 to 3 days after the last dose of antibiotics. And this is to make sure the bacterial infection has resolved. This is going to be based on another urine culture test. It's important to prevent, recognize, and treat a cat with a UTI. Because if it's untreated, it can result in a pyelonephritis or a kidney infection. In rare cases, that can result in acute kidney injury or acute kidney failure. Keep in mind that older cats seem to develop UTIs more often, especially cats that have certain underlying disease like chronic kidney failure, diabetes, or even hyperthyroidism. When in doubt, if you notice any signs such as increased thirst, larger or smaller clumps of urine in the litter box, lethargy, decreased appetite, weight loss, or muscle wasting, please check with your veterinarian sooner than later.